Hello everyone, it's a pleasure to be with you. My last talk was in just before Christmas, by the way. Now we are just after Easter. So I'm very, very pleased to be with you. Probably some of you already know what I will show. It's not really a jewel. It's not even a best kept secret jewel, but you might learn something. I will not deep dive, but explain to you some of the nice capabilities of 3D Experience CoTIA user interface. And you will see that it is much smarter. CoTIA V5 is very efficient, you know, but it's much smarter and it helps both the rookie, the newcomer, the newbie, but also the expert. Let's have a look. Here we go. So first of all, very simple, 3D Experience CoTIA takes benefit of the very, very last improvement which have been done on the graphical boards. So CoTIA, 3D Experience CoTIA takes the most benefit of the capability of your graphic hardware. It was not the case with CoTIA V5 because in CoTIA V5, we don't have this new infrastructure, new rendering engine. For us, for the Dassault, it's called NRE, like new rendering engine. And we really take the most of the graphical capability of your graphical card, not only for the high quality of the rendering, but also the speed when you are dealing with a lot, very large assemblies. Okay, so let's start. The idea is really to focus on the user interface of 3D Experience CoTIA, mainly in part design, the tool that most of our users are using every day, okay? So let's go. The idea is to design a brake caliper around that area, okay? So you can see I can first isolate my working context within this big assembly. And I will use a very nice capability of 3D Experience CoTIA called ghost filtering. Here we go. I just isolate, and everything which is not in my selection box is displayed as ghost. So I can understand my context, but I can really focus on the area I would like to work in. I will just create another window. And as you can see in my working context, I have my 3D curves, circles, lines, planes, and whatever. And I will just work like if I was opening a new drawing sheet, a white piece of paper, I will just start my design like I was used to in previous releases of CoTIA. So let's start. And you will see it's a real dual display. Everything which is created on the left part of the screen will be shown in the right part of the screen. But I am designing in context. I know what I am doing. Here, very nice new capability of 3D Experience CoTIA. Looks simple, but you saw I just click on a plane. And CoTIA proposed to me, okay, if you click on a plane, probably, Daniel, you would like to make a sketch. We will see the other options, okay? Let's go for the sketch. I am now a display which is just normal to the view of the sketch, or the plane, sorry. And here, I can design a profile. Again, if I want to do something, if I click on something, I can automatically use the commands that have been popped up by 3D Experience CoTIA. For example, if I click on a node, let's say an edge, not an edge, I will be able to do something, but if I click on a node, a vertice, sorry, I will be able to do maybe a fillet, maybe a chamfer. Here, I just want to add the constraints. Here we go. Another one. You see, if I want to change the value of this constraint, this offset value, I just have to click directly in the dialog box. There is no double click to do, okay? So just by doing that, we decrease the number of click by at least 2, because you are, most of the time, you are double clicking to enter a value of a given dimension or constraints. It's simple things, but it's really improving a lot the overall productivity of 3D Experience CoTIA versus the nice CoTIA V5. Clicking on vertices, and I can do a chamfer. I can directly click to get my value of the fillet. I selected my profile and I mirror it. Now I'm leaving the sketch. Now I'm clicking the sketch. And Ketia proposed to me, what would you like to do? Would you like to create the plane which is surrounding this planar sketch, or would you like to do a pad? Of course, I want to do a pad. I did not click on the pad command. I could have done that like I was used to do in CATIA V5. And if I am an experienced user knowing CATIA V5 like hell, I will probably first, when I'm moving from CATIA V5 to 3D Experience CATIA, use the icon command and then graphical entity. Okay. In this case, it's different. We select the graphical entity, and CATIA, depending on the selection, will propose to you different type of commands. Good news, I am not putting on the screen the dialog box. Sometimes, you know, they are big because there are a lot of options. And I'm really keeping most of the area of the window to display the 3D. Here, I will continue my job. I will do, you can see here, this is a classical pad dialog box, but you are not forced to use it. But of course, if you create a pad by just using the graphical entity, the pad command or the pad feature is created in the specification tree. It's typically done for rookie, newbie, because it helps to learn CATIA much more faster, but it's also very helpful for 3D experience CATIA newcomers coming from CATIA V5. Let's design another profile, okay, from a 3D projected curve, but also sketch line. I type in my dimension. I will exit the sketch once I have put the value of the fillet. My profile is in work. You see now I am clicking my profile and I have another icon because we take into account the context. It's really a smart user interface. We know that now you can not only do a pad, but you can also do a pocket because you can remove material. In the very first step, there was no material. Okay. So here in this case, let's go for still a pad, but I could have used a pocket. Let's continue the job. And you can see that everything which is done on my first window is of course displayed in the second window, in the context window. So I know what I am doing. Not only I am guided by CATIA when I'm designing, but I know what I am doing. Let's continue the job. I will create a small pocket inside this brake caliper. Just offset this 3D curve which has been projected on the sketch plane. And create, for example, a pocket. The pocket is created automatically in the current body. We can see it on the right screen. I will type in the right value. And you can see that here, in my context, I have the disc of the brake. So I know that I have to give more, maybe, allowance to my brake caliper not to be in collision with a brake disc. Let's continue the job. I will do some holes. That's classical. Something you also see that I have what we call the action pad. The action pad is a way for the user to put together all the commands he needs at a given time. And the good news is that even if you are in part design, you can add in the action pad, in your favorites, any command from generative shape design, sheet metal design, composite design, whatever. You just have to be at the same level between the various apps. Generative design is at part level, like part design. Assembly design will be at another, at the assembly level. So you cannot combine those, but you can combine the ones which are at the same level. Very, very helpful. And of course, you can add all the view, height show, all the cosmetic commands that you are using every day. You can also change the display. So if I was in V5, I should have go to tools, settings, I think it's display, performance, background, and so on. Here you just change the ambience and you can go from the white background to the blue background. You can even create some much more complex ambience if you want to make a quick snapshot and share a more realistic view with your peers. Let's go back to the basic one. So you can see it's very, very smooth, very fluid. We will continue the job. As you can see in 3D Experience Katia, all the commands are on the lower horizontal, the bottom of the screen, if I would say. But you can move them, you can dock them, you can undock them, you can gather various commands together, or you can add some favorites into the action pad. You can also dock the action pad, or the action pad can be floating, and just by hitting the B space, the B key of the keyboard, the action pipe will pop up where your mouse is located. So in this case, not only we are minimizing the mouse location, but we are also minimizing the number of clicks. It's why 3D Experience Katia is more productive than V5. You see, it's very simple. You can even have another screen if you are using two screens, like most of the designers. You can have all your commands, which are maybe put on the second screen and keep one bigger screen for the 3D. It's very simple. And you can reset it all the times because maybe you want to go back to the default settings. So I am continuing my job on my brake caliper. And here what I will do is I will just split in two this shape to have an upper and a lower caliper. But let's first finish the design of the caliper. So let's sketch again. Let's create a pad. You will see also a very, very nice new capability of 3D Experience Katia, which is when you are designing, when you are starting from scratch a new assembly, you are not forced to work at assembly level. You work at the conceptual stage in part design. And at the very end, you will see we have a magic command that will distribute all the bodies automatically in an assembly with different parts. But let's continue the job in the part design context. Create my small pad. I add a pad support. Here we go. Again, for those who are familiar with Katia V5, to learn or to move to 3D Experience Katia is a matter of minutes, okay? Not even hour, minutes. Let's continue the design, and I will just cut these guys in two. But before that, look, what we add in part design, for those who are familiar with part design in Katia V5, we add some nice commands which were only available in some add-on in V5, but which are now fully integrated in part design. And one of them is wall thickness analysis. So let's run a wall thickness analysis. The color is depending, of course, on the wall thickness. And here we might see that there is a little bit, it's a little bit too thin, 2 millimeters at the red areas. Another nice capability of 3D Experience Katia is the clipping. We can do clipping in V5. But in 3D Experience Katia, the clipping is permanent, you will see. Here, you see, I move my clipping plane. Sorry for the jaggies of the display. But here, you can work permanently with this clipping view. And here, very, very, very nice capability. Have a look. I click on the face of a cylinder. And I will just click on these prints on the snow. And this is, in fact, a navigation command. And it will help you to navigate in the complete history, the parents, the children, from a feature point of view, of this guy. So here, we can see that this was coming from a pocket, and we display the sketch in 3D directly. And you can just change one dimension of the sketch in 3D. You don't have to go back to the sketcher, or leave the sketcher, and so on. I change my thickness. Looks good to me. Let's double check that the thickness is good. So I run a check wall thickness analysis again. Looks better, 4 millimeters everywhere. It will be stronger. Of course, I continue to have the same capabilities than in V5. So for example, I can remove easily faces of the solid to remove an unwanted area. Here we go. I will continue the job. Let's do some holes now. So I will just add a small extension to receive a hole here. But here, for example, I want to make a fillet. I just click on an edge, and automatically Katia is popping up this command, edge fillet. I will click on Control, select another edge, because I would like to have the same fillet on both sides, and just here, type the value of the fillet. No need to open a command, edge fillet. Having this dialog box, selecting parameters, I only work directly in 3D. It's much more efficient. This being said, I continue the job. And in fact, I am just now cutting my caliper, this shape, in two pieces, the lower and the upper caliper. So here, this is a pretty simple command, split, copy paste with link of the body, split the first body, keep only the low part, and of course, split the other body by the same plane and keeping the upper part. So now I have my two brake calipers, lower and upper. I just rename them to be more efficient, and I will look at the spectre in later on. You notice that we do not manipulate that much the spectre, okay? Only to change some parameters, attributes of the feature itself, but not the the inputs, just attributes. Let's go to make some holes here. So let's do a particular hole at that location now. Another one here. And now I will show you another command, very nice, from 3D Experience Cutia, which is Semantic Painter. So here's my first hole. I decide to have a counter bore hole. So I select the counter bore option. It will be filleted. So I will just select my options of the cap screw. This is it. And now the idea is, oh, it looks nice to me. I would like just to replicate all the features of this particular hole. So I just use here the Semantic Painter. Katia is proposing to me some target holes to be given the same attributes. I just paste. And now all those holes receiving the same attributes as the first one. And this Semantic Painter works on fillet, on chamfer, whatever, on thickness. It just copy-paste feature parameters or feature types. Let's continue. This is a casting part. So I will start something which is not usually very easy, which is a draft design. So I can use a standard draft command of Katia, select the faces I would like to draft, select my neutral elements, select my parting surface, enter the draft angle, and that's it. But again, in 3D Experience Katia versus Katia V5, we added an auto draft command, which was only available in V5 in a special add-on. So here, the auto draft command works globally. I select my pulling direction, I select my functional faces, which are the faces that I do not want to be drafted, like all the holes, obviously. I will select my parting element. So my draft angle is 3 degrees. And in one shot, all the faces have been drafted. I will do the same for the other side of the caliper. So the same command, auto draft. I select the pulling direction, the faces I would like to ignore. Here we go. And in one command, and in the spectre, there will be only one feature, auto draft, not a serial of draft commands. So it's even easier for someone else who do not know my this design to continue the job if, for example, for any reason, I am put on another job. And at the end, I can use the draft analysis command to check that everything has been drafted properly on the right direction with the right angle, and the faces that should not be drafted are kept unchanged. Here we go. Now, I think I already showed you that it was some times ago in one of the Katia talk, but I think it's very nice. So forgive me if I show you that again, but it's the autofillet. It's also in the app part design. So everybody moving from V5 part design to 3D Experience Katia part design will get access to this command. You select the faces you do not want to be rounded, and then Katia will analyze a complete solid model, look at all sharp edges, and put a fillet, for example, of 1 millimeter on the all non-functional surfaces or edges that should be filleted, because this is a casting part, and casting part fillet is important. Here we go. You see it very fast, and I have all my part filleted. And now the very last command that I will use, just here, is to add a text, an engraving. I could have done an embossing, I would use an engraving. And in 3D Experience Katia, you can go in the sketcher, you can type in a text, select the font, select the height of the font, the size, and then you will project this text directly on the solid and create either a boss or a pocket. In my case, I will use a pocket. I will just here constraints the text versus some edges of the part, and then use the pocket function you see here. My brake caliper, I use pocket. So what you also see is that as I am not forced to move my mouse on the right side, on the lower side, on the bottom side, on the left side, because my menus are popping up under my mouse location, the mouse mileage is really drastically reduced. This is also a nice capability of 3D Experience Katia to display, for example, for marketing purposes, the capability, the nice rendering, I would say, of the design. Now, the last command I will show you today, but follow the next Katia talk, and you will also discover a new set of capability in assembly design. This is a distribute. Remember, I was doing my conceptual design in part design, in the solid modeling. You can see on the left, we have all the feature, the bodies that have been created. I see in this distribute definition, all the list of those entities. And now I will select the one I would like to be distributed individually in a new part and attach to an assembly. Here we go. And now I have just this assembly with all my parts. To continue the job, but this will be shown next time, I will just do some symmetry. And also you will see next time that I will show you a new capability of 3D Experience Katia, which is very effective, which is called Engineering Connection. Engineering Connection is a way to make both assembly constraints, this face is connected to this face, but also kinematic join in one command. So you, when you define the constraints between parts in an assembly, you will get kinematics motion analysis for free, but this will be shown next time. So I hope you got some new information, and I wish you a very, very nice end of day, nice end of evening, and talk to you next time. Thank you very much for your attention. Bye-bye, guys and ladies. Thanks.